The pitch. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. Dansby Swanson stands in.
The shortstop. Dansby Swanson.
Throw to first. Albies dives back in. That one's in there, 0-1. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Albies aboard here at first with nobody out. Albies on the move. Swing and a bouncer. And he's safe at first.
Well, just a classic case of finding a hole with that one. He didn't have to hit it real hard in that direction. Pretty much did the opposite of what you want to do with the pitch on the outside part of the plate like that. Just rolled over, but good hustle down the line and got the infield knock.
Now in for the Braves, Ronald Acuna Jr. Good power, not great in the OBP department. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
If you're going to be a championship type of ball club, you've got to hit with runners in scoring position. And after last night's struggles, I'm sure these guys are chomping at the bit to have this kind of opportunity here early in this game.
Now a screamer into the outfield. Canna makes the catch. And there's one away. Let's take a look at our lineup. And one to watch, of course, their three-hole hitter, Ronald Acuna Jr.
Yeah, definitely someone I always enjoy, you know, when I get a chance to watch him, whether he's hitting a game or even taking swings during batting practice. Man, this guy's always so focused on what he's doing on that task at hand. He's got so much attention to detail that when he steps in the box, his success.
To second, there's one. What a double play that was. Inning over. Now the Mets. Bottom of the first, and stepping in for New York, Jeff McNeil.
There you go.
The line to the pitch.
The second baseman. Yeah.
And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. And a foul ball. Kick, Sandios. Ball. That misses, and the count is even, 2-2. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Just kept it simple. Played Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
Brandon Nimmo stands in here, leaves that one off the inside. Nimmo lifts one in the air deep to right field, and that one is going to go. His fourth home run of the season, and the Mets on the board first. It's 2-0.
So many times a sinker inside is a foul ball off the ankle for the batter. But that time he did a really nice job of staying inside the pitch and getting through.
Here's Starling Marte.
Batting third. The center fielder.
First offering misses badly for ball one.
It can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Next offering is in for a strike. Next one misses, two balls and a strike. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone.
Back-to-back jacks, and this club is fired up right now, dude. I mean, this is the kind of thing where you really start to notice hitters in a lineup
This one swung on and hit well. Way back there. And out of here. Pete Alonso takes it deep, and they tack one on the board. It's 4-0. That's their third home run of the game.
They're having a lot of fun at the plate in this one. They've got the long ball working for them on autopilot.
J.D. Davis stands in here, leaves that one down. The next pitch misses. 2-0, the count. Singy, maybe some nerves getting the best of him in the first?
Well, it's hard to know exactly if it's nerves or not, but he just doesn't have it right now. Those hitters on the other side, they're going to say it's nerves and use that as a competitive edge to try to jump on him even more.
In for a strike, now 3-1. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. Popped up. Albies under it. Makes the grab. One away. Eduardo Escobar. El Caballo up to him.
Eduardo Escobar.
First pitch, not close.
1-0.
On the ground. Dives and he can't hang on. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Escobar out of the play. Two outs, base is empty. So up next for New York, Mark Canna. In there and it's 0-1.
Well, clear game plan coming in this one. Be aggressive against this starter. Try to knock him out of this ball game, and it looks like they're on their way to doing that. Get into the bullpen a little bit early. Could be a great offensive day.
First inning going a bit long. 23 pitches to this point. Swing and a miss. 1-2. The next offering misses. It's 2-2. Now. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. 2-2 now. And that skips in the dirt.
Wow, this guy's really battling up there as if his run is the game-winning run. I love his tenacity.
Line drive. Acuna makes the catch, and that'll do it. Second inning set to go. So here's the Braves' designated hitter, Ryan Zimmerman.
The designated hitter, Ryan.
He swings and misses at the first pitch. 0-1.
Well, early in this ball game, down by 4 runs, you've got to try to get a run back. And just look at taking at least one an inning. Before you know it, you'll be tied up.
Lane 11.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And that one off the outside edge. Just missed.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
And there's ball four.
Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a full scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Austin Riley looks at one outside there. Next pitch misses. 2-0. Runner at first with no outs here. Swing and a miss. And it's 2-1. Stays alive. Two now. That one misses. 3-2 now. Got him. One down.
Well, he throws him with a great fastball right on the corner. It's kind of like bowling, and you think the ball's going to get into the gutter, and somehow it just hangs onto that edge and knocks down a pin. Well, he got the outside corner of the plate and got that called third strike.
Alex Dickerson in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-1.
Well, as a hitter, you're hoping that the command on that sinker doesn't come until later in the ball game. But if that's how it's going to be all day, it's going to be a tough one for the offense.
Next pitch downstairs, and it's 2-1. At the belt and fires. Zimmerman leads off first with one away.
Looks like he's just sizing him up there. Really good pitch to hit, but he took it all the way. Sometimes guys just want to set their timing later on in the game. That may be
well, plays made there, and that retires the side. Back here at the ballpark, here's Francisco Lindor. And here it comes. Just missed.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Next pitch is outside. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
To the right side. On to first. And a quick out number one. Tomas Nido, the next to hit. Good defender. He's been inconsistent offensively. And first offering is fouled off. And a pitch. Fought off foul. Next ball. Offering down in the dirt.
12. One ball, two strikes.
And down on strikes. Two down. Jeff McNeil stands in.
The batter, number one, second baseman.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Next offering is in for a strike. Next offering way off the plate. In the air, left field, Swanson on the move, brings it in with a nice running grab. And that is that. We head on now to the top of the top half of the third inning, and now it's Travis d'Arnaud at the plate.
Leading off to the break, the catcher.
Here comes the pitch.
Travis d'Arnaud.
That's in there, going one. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Travis d'Arnaud hits one out. His second of the year, and they're on the board. It's 4-1.
Well, he put a really nice swing on that one, and everything was on time, took a direct path to the ball, excellent extension, and just drove it out of here. Nothing better than when the ball jumps off your bat like that.
Adam Duvall at the plate.
Batting up. The right fielder, number 14. Adam.
First offering misses the mark.
Oh, he's just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
Next one is off the plate, and that's ball two. Next offering clips the zone count even at two. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. So the lineup flips over, and now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Ozzie Albies. And he's already singled in this game. Out towards right center field. brings it in, and there are two outs. Two outs, bases empty. And next for Atlanta, Dansby Swanson. Pitch misses inside, 1-0. Nowadays with advanced metrics and aggressive defensive shifting, defense isn't necessarily just about making errors. Are you able to get to balls? Are you able to fill spots where guys hit the ball? The wide to kick the pitch. And there's a ball.
In an area that goes unnoticed is the coach that's responsible for positioning and then the research person that's providing the information. So what we're seeing in baseball, so many more people behind the scenes that are contributing to the success between the lines.
Two down, nobody on. And a strike in there. Back when you played, it wasn't the empirical data we have now. It was a guy with a ruler and a diamond taking a colored pencil and drawing a line where he thought someone had hit the ball, right?
That or just going off of gut or feel. What does it look like his swing is today? What's the pitcher throwing? They are sticking to the metrics and what seems to be most consistent for that hitter, regardless of who the pitcher is on the mound.
Payoff pitch. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. That one hammered center field. That's back. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases. Around second now as they still don't have it. Swanson headed for the plate. Puts the tag on him, leaving the box, and that's the third out.
Wow, and inside the Parker is really exciting. He almost made it, but instead a relay to the plate, and the tag just beat it. Man, that's a lot of effort for an out at the plate. Wild play to end the inning.
Back here at Citi Field, bottom of the inning. Now the number two hitter, Brandon Nimmo.
The right fielder.
And that's in for a strike.
Nimmo.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he looks fresh out there. Just needs to get a little more confidence and remember how good he's been in the past.
And that one is lifted in the air. Under it is Acuna to make the grab. And there's one down. Starling Marte up to him.
Number six, Starling Marte.
There's a strike. And a bunt towards third. And that's just foul. Here's the 0-2. And that chance handled. In plenty of time to first. And two straight set down to begin the bottom of the third.
Up next to the bat,
here's Pete Alonso.
The first baseman,
And that's in there for strike one.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, it will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Up the middle, Albies sends it to first, and that takes care of Alonso. And the back here in Queens, and now it's Ronald Acuna Jr. Peterson back to work. And first offering is fouled off. And a pitch. And a count 1-2.
Some real good life going through the zone on that one.
1-2 now. On Acuna. Good eye right there. Here's the 2-2. That gets down for a hit.
He needed out one. It's been a tough stretch to plate lately. Even with the pitch on the outside part of the plate, he still pulled that one into the outfield. The defense was ready for it with the shift, but no one could come up with it. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Peterson keeping him close. And now it's Matt Olson's turn to hit. Next offering is down low, and it's 1-0. So two balls and no strikes. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
Acuna gets his lead at first with nobody out. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Canna makes the grab, and there's one down. Here's Ryan Zimmerman.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Ryan Zimmerman.
Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Ziggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
Peterson throws over, and he's back safely. Next one misses, and the count is 1-2.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Next offering is fouled back. One, two now. Ripped on a line to center, and a base hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds at second with one gone.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes. Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
Here's Austin Riley. And the first offering is not close. Runners at first and second with one gone. Grounded to third, could be two. Over to McNeil, and that's two. On now to the bottom of the four. Welcome back, bottom four. Now it's J.D. Davis.
Leading up for the Mets.
First pitch, and he just misses.
Well, he hasn't quite settled in out there. Four runs in three innings. He's going to have some quick one, two, three innings.
Swing, and this one's blasted. It's got a chance. Pulls it in on the warning track. Eduardo Escobar up now for the Mets.
The third baseman, Eduardo Escobar.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Next offering is in for a strike. And base hit. One gone, runner at first. Here's Mark Canna.
Mark Canna.
First pitch just misses. He swings and fouls one off. The lefty ready, and a 1-1. Swing and a miss, and a count 1-2. Next pitch is inside, 2-2. Kicks and fires. Swing and a miss, and he got him. Two away.
Now, Boog, it becomes pretty difficult as a teammate when a guy's struggling like this. You don't know if you want to go up and tell him to keep swinging it or if you want to give him his space, what exactly he needs. But right now, it's clearly a struggle for him, and you're just hoping that somehow, some way, it'll click and he can get out of this as quickly as possible.
And the next pitch is way outside. Swing and a miss. And that is strike two. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that'll do it. Mets leave one. And welcome back. Now the left fielder, Alex Dickerson.
Leading off of the break, the left fielder.
A wind and a pitch.
Alex Dickerson.
Fouled off. He was late. Here's the 0-1. Not close with that one. And the count is 1-1. The 1-1 is cut on and missed to the pitch upstairs. Next offering misses. Two balls, two strikes. And down on strikes he goes. And the leadoff man set down in their half the fifth. Travis Darno. Next up for the Braves.
The catcher, Travis Darno.
Next pitch downstairs. Ball one. The 1-1. And that one fouled off. One down, base is empty.
Ball. Playing two balls, two strikes.
Tries to hold up, appeal to first. He did not go around. The pitch. In the air out to center. Marte pulls it down. That's out number two. And here is Adam Duvall. He's 0-1. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Next pitch is downstairs.
One ball, one strike.
Next offering is in for a strike.
2012, one ball, two strikes.
Next pitch, not close, up high. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. That's out number three. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Tomas Nito at the plate. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. And a pitch.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position, and that's what he does.
That's towards center. Acuna there. He's got it, and there's one away. Back to the top of the lineup, and now here's Jeff McNeil, one for two. First offering misses the mark.
Well, Boog, after watching the first inning of this one, you would not have expected that this pitcher would be in such a groove and still in the ballgame at this point.
And no one could get there. It falls in. Not stopping. He's going for three. The throw to third, and he's out, trying for three.
The triple is arguably the most exciting play in baseball, and the guys worked so hard to get around first, to get around second, to get thrown out at third. man, you just feel bad for him. On top of that, he's already in scoring position, so you think about how it kind of hurts the team as well.
Nimmo in the box with one away as he takes ball one. Hard ground ball, base knock. So two down, and next for the Mets, Starling Marte. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or a run and hit.
Next offering upstairs. There's a strike, 3-1. Nimmo off of first with two away. So now two on and two outs.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner into scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
Oh, one throw.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
The 0-1. And strike two. First and second, two down. The next offering misses. 1-2 to count. Tapped in front of the plate. Throws to first, and that takes care of Alonso. That ends the inning. Two left for the Mets as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. Back here at Citi Field. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Here's the second baseman. Ozzie Albies has some trouble with it.
Pretty much gifted a leadoff base runner right there. And as an offense, this is where you really want to take advantage. Apply some pressure this inning. Make that error hurt.
Runner at first following the error. And now the shortstop, Dansby Swanson. Roll to short, could be two. To second for one. Plenty of time at first. That's a double play. Now and back. Here is the Ronald Acuña Jr. And first offering is fouled off.
These guys like this that have so much power, look forward to seeing them hit the ball a long way. But if you're in the stands, or you're in a broadcast booth, or you're a writer, better keep your eye on the game.
The next pitch misses, and it's 2-1.
Definitely a frustrating day for the offense, but when they look at it, this guy's had his best stuff. Painting the corners, working on the edges, and changing speeds. Just a difficult one. You tip your cap.
Next one misses. 3-2 now. That's ripped. Base hit. Now he turns and heads for second. Throw, and it gets away.
Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Digging in, Matt Olson. This guy has turned into a beast. Foul ball there.
And the strategy of winning a ball game, when you can make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning.
Now that's strike three and the third out. So we take back here in Queens, John Schoppe with Chris Singleton in the booth, and leading off the bottom of the sixth, J.D. Davis.
J.D. Davis. Like, what's your name? How about we just told
tone it down, then go back to where you came from. I ain't gotta prove nothing now. One idea worth 100,000. So if that's about your budget now, in a room for discussion now, I'm trying to show and improve, ayy. Never get stuck in the past, that just ain't nothing I do, nah. Wanna push up with the crew, I bet that she call my bluff, yeah. Ayy, you know, baby, what's up?
Now time is called here. Pitching coach on his way out to the mound.
Small circle, that's crucial. She got it moving, vominos. I gotta get it pronto, yo. Sequence occurring. Mami, mi nombre es papi chulo. Mi nombre es papi.
Back down for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Darren O'Day. He's pitching on 2 days rest.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
The pitch. Good eye right there. And that's in there at the knees. That one missed.
You won.
Lifted in the air right center field. Duvall makes the play, and there's one down. Now Eduardo Escobar up now for the Mets.
Eduardo Escobar.
First offering, and it just misses. There's a swing and a drive. That's back there. And it's off the wall. Play at the plate, and he's out. He tried for the inside, the Parker, and he couldn't make it.
Bless you. Mark.
Mark Penn now at the plate. And that one fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. And Acuna able to make the grab. And that will end. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Seth Lugo. And he has some nasty breaking stuff.
Lugo.
Zimmerman, the leadoff batter, as he looks at ball one. Next offering is in for a strike.
In this situation, you expect the batters to be a little more patient, possibly take until they get a strike. With that, you don't want to miss your opportunity to get ahead early in the count. He didn't right there.
Next offering misses, and a count 2-1. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
Well, and those hitters count sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
The next offering misses. Ball three. Liner caught it second. So up next, Austin Riley.
Austin Riley.
That one's in there, 0-1.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
He swings and drives one out to deep left field. That one's back. Pulls it in on the warning track. Now it's Alex Dickerson.
Number 25, Alex Dickerson.
Well struck left field. Back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. He'll touch them all. His 12th of the season, and they slice into the lead. It's 4-2.
Oh, that one got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden, they're back in this ballgame.
Here's the catcher to hit, Travis d'Arno. He's already homered in this game. Swings through that one, 0-1. Started after the 0-1 pitch, and now a check down to first. Nope, he held back. Righty to the plate.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
Next pitch misses. 3-1 now.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
The 3-1 in for a strike, full count.
Just a really nice slider down and in there. He wants to get the hitter thinking fastball, speed him up, and just subtract some velocity and add a little movement.
Three balls, two strikes, the count. Out there to center. Marte racing over to make the catch. But not before they're able to draw closer with this blast. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the seventh. And the batter will be the shortstop, Francisco Lindor.
Not shortstop. Francisco Lindor.
The pitch. In for a strike, 0-1. Going 2 now. Ground ball, left side. Oh, what a stop. On the money, nice play.
Third baseman had to be so quick with their first step reactions. Hot shots like that, that's why they call it the hot corner. That's a perfect example, though. There's no way he gloves that one if he's not dialed in, anticipating something coming his way, staying on his toes every pitch. Really nice job to get back up, set himself, and make a strong throw across the diamond.
And that's a double.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Got a good pitch to drive, stayed short with his bat path to the ball, and caught it out front, and he stayed long in his follow-through. That's how you split the gap, and that's pretty much a double every time.
Now time is called here. Pitching coach on his way out to the mound. Tyler Matzik will take over on the mound. He last pitched 4 days ago, so he should feel pretty fresh.
Tyler Matzik.
Yeah, the batter now, Jeff McNeil. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Nito around third. Ball comes home, and he's dead at the plate.
I think the base runner thought he had a better jump on that than the third base coach, clearly, as he tried to score from second. Third base coach was trying to hold him up, had both arms up, but he ran through the stop sign, and that's a costly base running mistake.
Here's Brandon Nimmo, and it was a homer back in the first inning that got his day started at the plate.
Yeah, Boog, a two-run blast as fans were just still getting into their seats here at the ballpark. So if you showed up late to this one, you missed out on a big moment early on.
in there for strike one. Hit weakly on the ground. Olsen steps on the bag, and that's the third out. Mets straight. Adam Ottavino getting the call to the mound. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Back now, as it'll be a pinch hitter to lead off, Eddie Rosario.
Number 8, Eddie.
And he deals. Ball one, no strikes.
One ball, no strikes.
Next pitch, way upstairs. And the right-hander deals. And that's a strike. The pitch. And it's fouled away. Left-hand batter waits. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. One out.
Well, we saw a solid effort out of their starter, and the bullpen is following suit. It's just a good day as a manager or as a pitching coach. You can hand the ball off to multiple arms and get stability from all of their performances.
Albies, the next to hit, takes ball one. That one misses, and the count is 2-0. And now two balls and a strike. Next offering is down low.
3-1.
In for a strike. Now it's 3-2.
3-1 count, saying to himself, I've got to get a fastball here. Just spins a get-me-over breaking ball to bring the count full.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
What a battle. Not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that one.
Ryan Snitker making a move for a bat here. Michael Conforto, runner on first with one down for him. Pitch misses inside, ball one.
Now this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap, but you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame. With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
In the dirt. That's hard hit in the line. He can't get there. It's a base hit. Lead runner holds at third, so two runners in scoring position and just one out.
Now, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there. I love the approach he had right there with that pitch, not trying to do too much, but still looking to drive it, and that's exactly. exactly what he's able to do into the opposite field gap for the double. A chance now to even the score and maybe extend this game.
And here is Ronald Acuna Jr. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. As he waves at that one. Stirring in the bullpen for the Mets, Edwin Diaz, a right-hander with big strikeout stuff, is getting it fired up. Castro getting loose as well. Next pitch just misses, and that's ball one. Next pitch downstairs, and the count's even at two. Huge strikeout there.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed. It's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. They tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
Trevor May comes on now, and he'll go to work with runners on second and third. Olson stands in with two away as he takes a ball. Next pitch misses outside. 2-0. The 2-0 is in for a strike.
Cold night like tonight, last thing you want to do as a hitter is get jammed or even off the end. Trying to find that sweet spot on the bat. Tell you what, you're going to be trying to catch things out front, so off-speed pitches may be a good complement to that fastball.
Next pitch is outside. Back to work, 3-2 now. Checks his swing, now an appeal to third, and no swing, it's ball four.
Very close off the outside corner. Could have easily been called a strike in that location.
Ryan Zimmerman. Looks like it'll be a pinch hitter. Danny Santana. Pressure spot for him. Bases loaded and two gone. Santana. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Two now on the ground to first. Alonso takes it to the bag, third out. And a break. Staying in the game on defense, Eddie Rosario. He'll be the new right fielder after entering as a pinch hitter.
Now playing right field, number 8, Eddie.
Also into the ball game, Orlando Arcia. He's in at shortstop. Welcome back. Ready for the bottom of the 8th. Here's the center fielder, Starling Marte. Kenley Jansen into the game. It's his job to keep his team in the game. The wind of the pitch. And he drops it down the third baseline. And he grabs it in foul ground. Right-handed reliever. Soft contact in the air. Albies puts it away. One down. And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso, for the fourth time tonight. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Worm burner into the outfield for a knock.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
Now it's J.D. Davis, and a foul ball at the belt and fires. Maybe a two ball. 5-4-3. It's a double play, and that'll do it for the inning. 9th inning coming up. It's the Mets 4 and the Braves 2. The Mets with a new arm on the mound, Edwin Diaz. And he'll feature a hard slider to work off his fastball. We go to the ninth. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Austin Riley. Here comes a pitch. Strike one. Diaz. He's known as a reliever that excels in really tough situations, those high leverage spots. It seems like he's at his best in these situations, and obviously the ability to get the strikeout factors in. The pitch. Up the middle, and it finds its way through for a hit.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up. Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
Next offering is foul back.
Look out. That ball was smoked. Man, I am so relieved that they have this netting down the lines. Just ensures safety for the fans. Last thing as a player, you want to look up and see a fan get hit.
And that one in the air center field. Marte makes the grab. And there's one away.
Yeah, there are certain guys that expect to come in and dominate, and they see the challenge, the battle, just a little bit differently. They trust their stuff, and they believe that their stuff is better than that guy standing in the batter's box, what his swing, what his ability is.
D'Arnaud in the box now. No balls and a strike. Next offering is downstairs. The mental approach is a big factor too, isn't it?
Yeah, Boog, it is. And, you know, for each guy, it can be a little different. Some people consciously work on focusing, slowing things down, breathing techniques. And then there's some players that are just natural, and they just seem to be more composed and less excitable.
Next offering popped in the air, right field. Nimmo puts the squeeze on that one, and there's two down. A lot of times with relievers, they just like to get amped up. And they're not really looking to try and slow it down, right? They're just trying to get hyper.
Yeah, and perhaps make that hitter a little hyper and make him more aggressive. And that way, when they put a wrinkle, change speeds, he's out in front just a little bit.
Next offering is foul back. Riley off of first with two away. Ground ball to the right side. And that'll do it.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
And your final 4-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
For our ball game tonight, for the victorious New York Mets, 4 runs on 11 hits, 1 error. They left 5 men on.